This is Merryn Jose and you're listening to MerlianPodcast.com. Today we have the great pleasure of speaking with Carole Hart. Carole Hart is an award-winning director, producer and writer. She began her career as one of the original writers of Sesame Street, then moved on to other programming for children, including the best-selling Free to Be You and Me, a record album, book and television special. She has also produced a number of movies for television. Most recently, Carole is completing a feature documentary entitled For the Next Seven Generations. The documentary tells the story of 13 indigenous grandmothers, shamans, medicine women and healers, from all parts of the world who came together in 2004 to form a council, the International Council of 13 Indigenous Grandmothers. Since then, they have travelled together around the world from Dharamsala, India, to the Amazon rainforest, to the mountains of Oaxaca, Mexico, and more. Carole and her cameras have accompanied these women, documenting their travels, their prayers, and how they have touched and changed the lives of those around them. So a warm welcome to Merlian Podcast, Carole. It's so nice to have you on the show today.
It's so wonderful to be with you, Merryn, and I really appreciate the opportunity to talk about the grandmothers in this movie.
So tell us, how did the International Council of Grandmothers first start? Because it's fascinating. The whole thing is fascinating.
It was pretty magical. There's a woman named Jyoti who is a spiritual teacher who lives in Northern California, and over her lifetime of work, she's made a lot of contacts with indigenous people, both Native Americans and around the world. And at some point a few years ago, she started having a vision in her head of a group of elder women, indigenous women, sitting in a circle.
Mm-hmm.
And she had no idea what that meant, but she couldn't get it out of her head. And then she was on her way to meet an indigenous healer shaman in Africa, in Gabon, Africa, named Bernadette. And when she met her, she mentioned to Bernadette that she had been carrying this vision, this circle of women, and Bernadette said, "I've been seeing the same thing. We have to make it happen."
Oh, my goodness, yeah.
And so they did.
Mm.
And they brought, through their various relations, they brought 13 indigenous grandmothers from around the world together, and every time they went to a grandmother they knew, they would explain the situation to them, and some of the grandmothers would say, "It's not me, but try so-and-so."
All right.
And every time they found a grandmother that it was, that grandmother had said, "I've been told in prophecy that there would come a time when I would have to be come together with a group of indigenous grandmothers to heal the planet when we would be in a lot of trouble."
Why the number 13?
Well, 13 is a magical number in almost every indigenous tradition around the world. There are 13 moons in their year.
Mm-hmm.
There are 13 eagle feathers in the eagle's tail to balance it, so it's a very balancing number.
I see.
And when they got to the 13th grandmother, they knew that they were in the right place, and they stopped.
Oh, that's very interesting. I didn't know that. So at what stage in the council's formation did you decide to make a documentary? I mean, how did this idea come about?
Well, there's two parts to that answer. The first part was that I have had personal experiences with indigenous healing ways. In 1994, I was diagnosed with a terminal lung cancer that had metastasized to my brain. And my husband and I went to see 12 oncologists, all of whom told me I had 3 to 4 months to live. And miraculously, I was brought into, I was introduced to Jyoti, who's a healer and who works with Native American ways. And she sponsored a Native American church meeting for me,
yes,
which is a healing meeting that's very intense and powerful, and it lasts 13 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And when I emerged from that, I knew that every cell in my body had shifted in some way. And I was working at that time with an oncologist, and I came home and I said, I can't do any more work with you.
Mm-hmm.
My body is ready now to continue healing itself. And it did.
And what did he say when you said that? I mean, was he shocked?
He told me he was shocked. He told me I was mad. He told me I was killing myself, that this was a suicidal move, that I had so many hundreds and millions of cancer cells in my body that it could never take care of itself. And I knew that something had happened in that meeting that meant that if I continued with his medicine, I probably would die. But if I just stayed with the healing I'd gotten, and they told me when I got the healing that it would take a few years for my body to catch up, so I, you know, continued being surveyed, and I did scans for 5 years, and we watched the cancer go away.
So he must have been absolutely amazed.
Yes. This. I mean, well, I wasn't amazed because I knew it.
No,
I don't know how to say how I knew it, but I knew it.
Oh,
you know?
I know about that knowing. That knowing.
Right.
Yeah.
So I never went in and took a CAT scan with any anxiety.
No.
Because I knew what it would show, and finally there was one little spot in the lung where the original lesion was, and so they watched that for 2 more years and declared that it was a scar tissue because it had not changed an iota.
So your oncologist must have been absolutely, truly amazed.
No, his reaction to it all was that I'm a statistical anomaly.
really?
But anyway, that got me into being, you know, deeply into Native American healing ways. When this happened with Jyoti and we saw that we were going to bring all of these grandmothers from around the globe together, it felt to me like that was historic and that it needed to be documented on film.
Mm-hmm.
And since that's what I do, I'm a filmmaker,
right.
We got the grandmothers' permission and we began filming them. And I thought that it would be one gathering that would be the historic event. And then when they decided to make a formal alliance and to continue their work and to travel around the world bringing their message, I found myself now, you know, 4 years of my life.
I believe you're calling the film for the next 7 generations, is that correct?
That is correct.
Yes, and why, what is the significance of the title?
Well, it's a wonderful idea that comes from the constitution of the Iroquois Confederacy. The Iroquois Confederacy was a series of tribes like the Mohawks and the Eries that occupied the entire northeast United States before the colonists got here.
Yes.
And they had their own constitution. They were very advanced. And the major part of their constitution was what they called the Great Law of the Iroquois, which said, in all deliberations, we shall consider the impact of our decisions on the next 7 generations.
Of course.
And so that's what they do. And that's become a way of life for most Indians. They meet in council and they, when they have important decisions to make, they play it out for that amount of time. Unfortunately, that is the one law we left off of our constitution.
Exactly. And that's
why we had it, it would be a very different world today.
Yes, so true. So how close are you, Carole, to completing the film?
Well, we've completed the first act, and I've been screening that for people, and they find it extremely moving. We're well deep into the second act, and I think that we will have it finished before the end of the year.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah, it will be wonderful after. I mean, because it literally will have been 5 years. We have over 600 hours of video from the first gathering to a gathering outside of Santa Fe, New Mexico, to a beautiful top of the mountain village where in Mexico where grandmother Julieta lives. to the Brazilian Amazon, where we have two grandmothers. Mm-hmm. And then we went with them to Dharamsala, India, where, among other things, they had a 90-minute meeting with the Dalai Lama.
Yes, I saw that wonderful YouTube.
Yes, and then we went to Pine Ridge, South Dakota, to the reservation there where our two Lakota grandmothers live. It's taking a while because we're pulling it all together, but we've made trailers.
Yes.
And a DVD of excerpts from the gathering in Dharamsala that can be seen on YouTube and also on our website.
We'll give all that information at the end of the interview because that's really important for people to see and hear.
Right.
So what impact do you hope the seven generations will have?
We've been with them as they've been traveling around the world. And when they talk about what's going on in the planet, they talk about it out of their deep love for their mother Earth. I mean, it's a love that one would have for a mother.
Mm.
When they talk about the damage that's been done, you can see and feel the heartbreak that that's causing them. It makes it very real. It makes people very conscious of their relationship to a living planet. And it changes their consciousness. You know, they work with social activist coalitions as well.
Mm-hmm.
And they inspire them and they help them. And what they're letting people see it is very late, but that there are solutions, but we have to change in order to embrace them.
Exactly.
And people are changing when they come in contact with the grandmothers.
And this is the effects of Al Gore's film.
Yes, definitely. We talk about For the Next Generations as being the spiritual underpinnings of his movie.
That's wonderful. You had a quote from a Rita Pitka Blumen's
I do, yes.
Can you give us that? I can't even pronounce the long name, actually.
Her name is Rita Pitka Blumenstein. She's a Yupik grandmother, which means she's an Eskimo from Alaska.
Oh.
And she looks like an Eskimo from Alaska, and she introduces herself as saying, "My name is Rita Pitka Blumenstein. I don't look like a Blumenstein, but I am." Her husband was a Jewish man from Brooklyn.
That's wonderful.
Her children call themselves Jewskimos.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Right.
So what was her quote? What
she said, and she said many, many wonderful things, but this one really says it all for me. When we can heal ourselves, we also heal our ancestors, our grandmothers, our grandfathers, and our children. When we heal ourselves, we heal Mother Earth.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's very beautiful.
And she added to that, you know, it can't change, it won't change unless we change,
yes,
all of us.
Of course. To change the world, we have to change ourselves.
Right.
Yeah. So, Carole, can you give us a website or somewhere where our listeners get a contact number?
Okay, well, if they go to our website, it's www.forthenextsevengenerations, and the seven is a number, and it's all one word, .com.
Okay.
And the YouTube address is youtube.com/... Carole, Carole, Hart, Hart.
Oh, that's wonderful, Carole. Will you come back again in the fall and give us an update on what's happening with the grandmothers?
Of course.
Oh, that would be lovely. Thank you again, Carole.
Thank you, Merryn.
So, for articles and book reviews on the grandmothers, please visit our online magazine, www.merliannews.com. And this is Merryn Jose, and thank you for listening.